This is Srinivas. In this video, we are going to learn how to solve the given system of linear equations by using matrix inversion method. Let us see one problem. Let us write first given system of linear equations. So we will be given three equations to solve. So let's write the three equations. We can copy these three equations from question paper. First equation, 5x minus 6y plus 4j equals to 15. Second equation, 7x plus 4y minus 3z equals to 19. Third equation, 2x plus y plus 6z equals to 46. Okay. Now we are asked to solve these three equations. Solving of equations is nothing but finding of unknowns. Here x, y, z are known as unknowns. These are also known as variables. Let us convert the given equations into matrix form. Let us write matrix form of the given system is. A into x equals to d. As a result, we are going to get three matrices, A, x and d, where A is called as coefficient matrix, where A is equals to coefficient matrix. X equals to, second matrix, x equal to variable matrix, capital D is equals to constant matrix. So by seeing the equations, given equations, we can write these matrices. Coefficient matrix. How to write coefficient matrix? By using the coefficients of x, y, z. Here 5, minus 6, 4. Don't forget to write symbols also. Minus symbol especially. 5, minus 6, 4 is the first row. Second row, 7, 4, minus 3. Third row, 2, 1, 6. Okay, now we have prepared coefficient matrix. Next, variable matrix. Variable matrix can be prepared by using variables. X, Y, Z are the variables. So this is a column matrix. Variable matrix is a column matrix. Next, constant matrix. Constant matrix can be prepared from constants. 15, 19, 46 are the constants. 15. 19, 46 are the constants. Now for writing this information, you will get 1 mark. Okay. Now we wanted to solve the given equations in a matrix inversion method. So if you remind, once again the form of matrix, Ax equals to D. Our aim is to find unknowns involved in variable matrix. So indirectly we are asked to find variable matrix. So capital X is equals to, now on shifting A from LHS to RS, become A inverse into D. So X equals to A inverse into D is the formula. This suggests you to find A inverse. Already we have D, we need to find D, D already given. A inverse we have to find. With the help of A, we can find A inverse. A inverse is the inverse matrix of A, and we know very well how to find inverse. We will learn in further process. Roughly, if I remind formulas, okay, A inverse formula, we had adjoint of A by det A. A inverse formula, adjoint of A by det A. To find A inverse, we need to find two things, adjoint of A and det A. Of these two things, better to find det A first, because sometimes you may get det A 0. If det A value 0, something by 0 going to be infinite. That's why, so to know whether it is 0 or not equal to 0, better to find det A first. If det A equals 0, those kind of systems cannot be solved by using matrix inversion method. Okay, so let's go to det A. So det A we can write from A, matrix A. There is only the difference between symbols. Here we use matrix symbol because this is a matrix. determinant symbol, because this is determinant of matrix. Same elements we have to keep here in determinant symbol. 5, minus 6, 4, 7, 4, minus 3, 2, 1, 6. Okay, now simplification. In general, we find determinant of a 3 by 3 matrix by using first row elements. In first row, I have 5 as the first element. So 5 in 2. 5 present in first row, first column. So on eliminating first row, first column, we left with 4 minus 3, 1, 6. 4 minus 3, 1, 6. Next we have minus 6. So we should write plus 6. Don't forget to change the symbol of the middle element, minus 6. So minus 6 should be replaced with plus 6 here, plus 6 into. Now minus 6 present in first row, second column. So eliminate first row, second column. We left with 7 minus 3, 2, 6. Write those elements here. 7 minus 3, 2, 6. Next we have 4 plus 4. 4 is nothing but plus 4. 4 into 4 present in first row, third column. So on eliminating first row, third column, we left with 7, 4, 2, 1. Write these elements here. 7, 4, 2, 1. So now that A equals to 5 into, let's go for further simplification process. Here AD minus BC formula. To find 2 by 2 determinant, use AD minus BC, or just like cross multiplication. 4, 6 are 24 minus BC, minus 3 into 1, minus 3. Plus 6 into, here 7, 6 are 42 minus BC, minus 3 into 2, minus 6, minus of minus 6. Plus 4 into AD, 7 into 1, 7, minus 4, 2 are 8. So now further simplification, that A equals to 5 into 24 plus 3, minus into minus 3 plus 3, plus 6 into 42 minus into minus 6 plus 6, plus 4 into 7 minus 8 minus 1. Okay, matrix A is useful in further process. So let me keep matrix A here. 5 minus 6, 4, 7, 4, minus 3, 2, 1, 6. As well as D. D is also useful. 15, 19, 40, 6. Now, that A equals to 5 into 24 plus 3, 27. Plus 6 into 42 plus 6, 48. Plus 4 into minus 1, minus 4. Plus into minus, minus. So, minus 4. So, that A equals to 5 into 27 on simplification, 5 7 are 35, 5 to the 10 plus 3, 13, 135, plus 6 8 are 48, 6 4 are 24, plus 4, 28, minus 4 as it is. So this is 135 plus 284. So an addition, 284, 135, an addition, 4 plus 5, 9, 8 plus 3, 11, 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4, 419, 419, which is not equal to 0. I got data value 419. So if data is not equal to 0, we can proceed further. Since data A not equals to 0, the given system can be solved. The given system can be solved by using matrix inversion method. Matrix inversion method. Okay, for finding that A, you are going to have one mark. That A value I got 419, which is useful in further process. Okay, now we found that A, na? Next we need to find adjoint of A. Adjoint of A formula. Transpose of cofactor matrix of A. Adjoint of A is known as cofactor matrix of A, whole transpose. So before we find adjoint of A, we need to find first cofactor matrix of A. Okay, let us find cofactor matrix of A. Cofactor matrix of A. four factor matrix of A. Definition: replacing each and every element of A with their corresponding cofactors. The matrix obtained by replacing each and every element with their corresponding cofactors. So we need to find cofactor of each and every element. Cofactor of 5, cofactor of minus 6, like that. So let us find cofactor of 5. So we have formula to find cofactor of any element. Cofactor of any element. Every element will be in the form of Aij, where I represent row position, j represent column position. So cofactor of Aij formula: minus 1 whole power I plus j into minor of Aij. So how to get minor of Aij? Minor of Aij is the determinant. Determinant obtained by deleting the row and the column where that Aij present. Okay. So at the time of finding each and every cofactor, you can understand easily. So let us concentrate on finding of cofactor of 5. So to find cofactor of 5, use this formula: minus 1 whole power I plus j. Here 5 present in first row first column, that's why first row first column, that's why 1 plus 1 into minor. I told you minor is the determinant. Determinant obtained by deleting first row first column. First row, first column. We left with 4 minus 3, 1, 6. Write these elements. 4 minus 3, 1, 6. Minus 6. Formula: minus 1 whole power. Minus 6 present in first row, second column. First row, second column. That's why minus 1 whole power, 1 plus 2. Now delete first row, second column. In order to get these determinant elements, delete first row, second column. On deleting first row, second column, we left with 7 minus 3, 2, 6. 7 minus 3, 2, 6. Next, cofactor of 4. Formula same, minus 1 whole power. 4 present in first row, third column. 4 present in first row, third column. That's why minus 1 whole power, 1 plus 3 into det. So to get this determinant, delete first row, third column. Now 7, 4, 2, 1 remain. 7, 4, 2, 1 remain. So we have to apply the same procedure for rest of the elements. 7 present in, okay, minus 1 whole power. 7 present in second row, first column. Second row, first column. Now to get this determinant, remove second row, first column. On deleting second row, first column, we left with minus 6, 4, 1, 6. Minus 6, 4, 1, 6. Next, 4 present in, 4 present in second row, second column. Second row, second column. Now to get determinant, remove second row, second column elements. Then left with 5, 4, 2, 6. 5, 4, 2, 6. Next, minus 3 present in second row, third column. That's why 2 plus 3. Det. On deleting second row, third column, we left with 5 minus 6, 2, 1. 5 minus 6, 2, 1. Next. 2 present in third row, first column. On deleting third row, first column, we left with minus 6, 4, 4 minus 3. Minus 6, 4, 4 minus 3. Next, minus 1 whole power. This 1 present in third row, second column. Third row, second column. Now we left with, on deleting third row, second column, we left with 5, 4, 7, minus 3. 5, 4, 7, minus 3. Next, minus 1 whole power. On deleting, okay, 6 present in third row, third column. On deleting third row, third column, we left with 5, minus 6, 7, 4. 5, minus 6, 7, 4. Just if you write these elements carefully, the remaining procedure will be easy. Now simplification part. Usage of formula finished. Simplification part. Minus 1 whole square. 1 plus 1, 2. Minus 1 whole square is what? 1. So 1 into. To find this determinant, use AD minus BC formula. 4, 6 are 24 minus BC minus 3 into 1 minus 3. Next, minus 1 whole cube, minus of, minus 1 whole power odd number, minus, minus of, use AD minus BC formula, 7, 6 are 42, minus, BC, minus 3 into 2, minus 6. Next, minus 1 whole power 4, plus only, 7 into 1, 7, minus 4 to the 8. Next, minus 1 whole cube, minus, minus of. Okay, when you have minus, keep bracket. Next, AD, minus 6 into 6, minus 36, minus 4 ones are 4. Next, minus 1 whole power 4, plus AD, 5, 6 are 30, minus BC, 4, 2 are 8. Minus 1 whole power 5, minus of. If it is odd number, you will get minus. The power is odd number. Next, AD minus BC formula, 5 ones are 5, minus BC, minus 6 into 2, minus 12. Next, minus 1 whole power 4, plus only, minus 6 into minus 3, plus 18, minus 4 fours are 16. Minus 1 whole power 5, minus of 5 into minus 3, minus 15, minus 4 into 7, 28. Next, minus 1 whole power 6, plus only, 5 fours are 20, minus, minus 6 into 7, minus 40. Now, simplification, 24 plus 3, 24 minus into minus 3, plus 3, minus of 42 plus 6, 42 minus into minus 6, plus 6, 7 minus 8, minus 1. Next, minus of minus 36 minus 4, minus 40, 30 minus 8, 22, minus of 5 plus 12, minus 3 minus 12 plus 12, 18 minus 16, 2, minus of, minus 15 minus 28, minus 43, 20 as it is minus into minus plus 42. Now we can write cofactor matrix of A, cofactor matrix of A. Twenty-four plus 3, 27. Minus 42 plus 6, 48. So minus 48. Minus 1. Minus of minus 40 plus 40. 22 as it is. Minus 17 as it is. 2 as it is. Minus of minus 43 plus 40. 20 plus 42, 60. So this is the cofactor matrix of A. Now, by using cofactor matrix of A, I can write adjoint of A. So adjoint of A formula, cofactor matrix of A, whole transpose. Now I can write adjoint of A, transposing cofactor matrix of A. So transpose of a matrix is nothing but interchanging of rows into columns. If I wrote first row as first column, I will get 27 minus 48 minus 1. Second row as second column, 40, 22 minus 17. Third row as third column, 2, 43, 60. So this is our adjoint of A. So after finding adjoint of A and as well as delta A, I can write A inverse. A inverse formula, adjoint of A by det A. 1 by det A into adjoint of A. We can also say 1 by det A into adjoint of A. 1 by det A value we got, det A value 490 into adjoint of A. Right, same matrix, adjoint of A. 27, 40, 2. Minus 48, 22, 43, minus 1, minus 17, 60. After finding A inverse, now let us remind formula. To find capital X, we had formula A inverse into D. So that equals to A inverse, substitute A inverse as well as D. A inverse 1/419 into 2742 minus 48 22 43 minus 1 minus 17 62 into D, D constant matrix 15 19 46. Now capital X is equals to 1/419 into, now multiplication of two matrices, we can do rows versus columns. First row, first column, in that first element into first element plus second element into second element plus third element into third element. 27 into 15 plus into plus plus 40 into 19 plus into plus plus 2 into 46. First row, first column finished. Next, second row, first column. Here also change the row. Second row, first column. In that again, first element into first element. Minus into plus, minus 48 into 15. Next, plus into plus, plus 22 into 19. Plus into plus, plus 43 into 46. Next, third row versus first column. Third row, first column. This is the third row, first column. So minus 1 into 15. Minus 1 into 15. Minus 17 into 19. Plus into plus, plus 62 into 46. Now on simplification, capital X equals to 1/419 into 27 into 15. 15 sevens are 105. 10, 52s are 30 plus 10, 40, 405 plus 19 fours are 76. So 760 plus 46 into 2 times 92. Next, minus into plus minus, 15 eggs are 120, 15 fours are 60 plus 12, 720 plus 92s are 38, 92s are 38 plus 3, 41, 480 plus 43 into 46, 46 into 43, 36 are 80, 34s are 12, 13, 46 are 24, 44s are 16, 18, 8, 3 plus 4, 7, 1978. 36 are 18, 12, 13, 46 are 24, 8, 3 plus 4, 7. Okay, 1978. Next, minus 15, minus 19 sevens are 133, 19 ones are 19, 29, 32, 323, plus 62 into 46. 62 into 46. 62 is 12, 66 are 36, 37, 42 is 8, 46 is 24. 2, 8, 2, 8, 5, 5. Now, capital X equals to 1/419 into, let us add 760, 90, 850, 852. Okay, 852. 857 400, 857 400, 1257. 1257. Next, let us add these two first. 1978, 480. 1978, 480. 8 plus 8, 16. 9. 23, 96. Subtract 720. 6, 9 minus 2, 7. 13 minus 7, 6. 1676. Next, let us add these two. 323, 338, 2852 minus 338. 12 minus 8, 4. 11 minus 3, 8. Sorry. 4 minus 3, 1. 8 minus 3, 5. So 2514. Now capital X is equals to, now each element we have to divide by 490. 1257 by 419, 1676 by 490, 2514 by 490. So here capital X is nothing but x, y, z, because you are going to get values of x, y, z. Now 419 1 times, 419 3 times, 419 1 times, 419 4 times, we will get 1676. 419 1 times, 419 6 times, so 3, 4, 6. So for finding up to adjoint A, 2 marks. For finding up to adjoint A, 2 marks. Okay. Next, for remaining part, 2 marks. We can write solution of the given system is, solution of the given system is x equals to 3, y equals to 4, z is equals to 6. For writing up to here, we will get 2 marks. Or 7 marks.